Hey everybody, welcome to a teamer mid-range video for channelfireball.com. This is a deck Andrew Jessup designed. I wrote a deck guide about it yesterday. Really strong deck, a lot of good cards. And there's the deck and sideboard. This is one of the many decks in standard right now that just uses the Gruul shell. And part of the reason why it wins is because the Gruul cards are so good. Now, of course, the blue cards in this deck, Auron's Epiphany, are also very good. I'm quoting somebody made this point on Twitter, like, forget who it was. They made a joke and said, like, oh, look at this great deck, and it was just the Gruul show with a bunch of bad cards. So I'm sort of copying it, and the difference here is I think the blue cards are quite strong. I'm going to keep this hand. It's a little bit weak on the draw. Looks like we're probably up against White Weenie. We're going to need to draw another land. If we have a fair amount of play with just two lands here. With just three lands, I mean. I'm not going to foretell Epiphany. I actually played the wrong land. I shouldn't play Forest because I have Vine, Glimmer, Snarl in my deck. I assume our opponent's playing White Weenie anyways. Though they didn't play a spell, but I don't know what deck would play Kabira Takedown and Snow Covered Plains. But they had three lands and didn't do anything, so. Well, Lyra's gotten feisty. I'm just gonna assume it is. I like to take out a couple Epiphanies because of Elite Spellbinder. And like to take out a couple of Magdas because it's not that good if you don't draw the Sentinel because it can't really attack. I mean, you can, but they often have a bigger creature or even just a crappy 1/1 token or something to block with. It's possible they're not playing White Weenie, though. I don't know what else to plan for, but they just didn't do anything. All right, so this is a decent hand. We have tap Shatterskull and untap Snarl. Yeah. I think this is actually a good card. You can often kill two creatures, but we're land light and it's only our second red. So we also have a 5-mana card. I think maybe I should just, you know, I'm going to wait in case of Verdane. It's weird if they just make another token. It's kind of like. I'm just going to take it. This might be too passive. Yes, I am so smart. I think I'm just going to smash the 1/1. It's true that is our third land for Goldspan Dragon, but the Chariot comes next turn. Except if they have like another Redain, I probably will just lose. All my cards cost 100. Okay. That's a good card, but we can beat it. I'm not saying we will beat it, but we can beat it. I think I should play this as an island, just in case I draw another Vine, Glimmer, Snarl. All right, maybe we got trouble. Thank you. possible I should wait, try to get them to do something too aggressive, but a little bit worried that there's some kind of protection spell that I can't remember in the format. I also kind of just feel like if I untap, I'll probably win. Okay. Maybe I should have attacked more, but I thought I'd. They have a lifelinker and I can sort of see what develops. Actually decent. Okay. Maybe I'll draw another epiphany. Nope. Well, I guess I'll do nothing. So the question now is, should I just make another 8/8? Kind of feel like I should. We have six creatures, they can attack with seven. Well, that's really bad. Somehow, probably only one or two of those that they can draw, and it's like drawing a lot of spells. That's a really good draw for us, though. Removal for the intrepid adversary is going to be good for us if we ever draw it. Trying to figure out. I mean, we can't really do much. We have four creatures that can block flyers, and they're gonna have five flyers. I could just cast it, but there's really no need. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. That's good because that life is important. We also have a removal spell. I don't really know how we break the stalemate other than potentially our opponent getting overzealous. Guess maybe we're just already in trouble. I mean, get to kill, eat two of those, trade here, jump here. Seems fine for us. Just get our free treasure. Okay, so we can attack with the den to gain a life. I think we need to make another 9/9. So we will only have three creatures that can block flyers, so we'll take two. Gain two life if we send this in. I also need to tap a creature to attack with the chariot, which I guess is okay because they're going to want to eat our chariot. They can't eat both our creatures. So let's see. They're going to have six flyers. So we block the three big ones. We take three. We'd be at three. And then we'll have one, two, three, four, five more blockers. And they'll have one, two, three, four, five, six more attackers. So their lowest ground creature is a two, so I think we'll live if we play this way. Oh no, I miscounted. We're only gaining one life. Well, actually, does that mean I'm better off having another ground blocker? It's only going to gain one, prevent two. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight creatures. So the three flyers get through. So I have one, two, three, four, five, six. So one ground creature gets through. So that's five. I think I'm going to be dead. But attacking here doesn't actually help me. Unless I'm missing something. Oh, it's because I go to two. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. So two get through. I don't know. You get through. I think maybe I'm fine. Did walked, it jumped instead of just eating it with the monk. Huh. Guess they saw I cast this play with fire. They don't want to maybe just be dead. I think I have 9 blockers and they have 10 attackers. So the fact that I can only block 3 of the flyers doesn't really matter. Well, that's probably very bad. Although, I suppose I can't get rid of my reach creatures. Okay. Well, that is a damn fine draw. I was trying really hard to figure that port out. There were a lot of creatures in play. I think I was okay, but I'm not sure. I'll have to go back and watch it later. Sorry, sometimes I keep some records. If you head over to my Twitter, I tweeted some new stuff coming from Ultimate Guard today. It is a Frozen World collection. It comes with a playmat with really awesome looking artwork, a boulder exclusive to the collection, and a pack of white katana sleeves, which come in the standard size. So you can check out my Twitter at Huey Jensen, their Twitter at Ultimate Guard. Looks like some awesome new stuff. You know, I'm a big fan of their stuff, and I've been proud that they sponsored me for quite some time. So if you wouldn't mind taking a look, would appreciate it, and thank you. Right, how's this hand? Kind of a perfect hand. Okay. I mean, we have 2, 3, 4. And we have all our mana. Mana can be rough in this deck, I must confess. Let's play this as a blue. What are we up against? Maybe just a normal Gruul deck. You never know. Oh, is this a blue land? Maybe the same deck. Do they have the chariot? Yes. Guess we just attack. We've got vigilance, so. Try to remember to play your basic forest last if you can because of the Vine Glimmer Snarl. I made that mistake once, trying to help you from making my mistakes. So this is okay. Like, I can trade the tracker for the chariot. It's weird if they crew, it's a little bit harder for them to block unless they like could I, if they have another chariot, it's a big problem for us, but Interesting. So they did nothing. Okay. Think I'm just gonna attack. I mean, I don't think people are playing a lot of cards that are good against the Chariot. I mean, they could have Burning Hands or something in their deck. Also have Dragon's Fire if they try to go for a double block. I think I'll just play it. I mean, even if they have their own Dragon's Fire, probably we're going to kill both of their tokens. And Chariot's not that good if you don't have any tokens. They must have a handful of Dragons and Epiphanies, which, if they have an untapped red here plus Dragon, oh, they have Ren. Well, that's a big problem, I suppose. I guess I'll have to block. But now we're going to be brick walled by Ren. There any way they don't just block my chariot? Kind of think I'm fine with it. Should have played my other creature before combat. What color? I guess I tap a blue. Sure. Doesn't even really do anything. Hard to get through a bunch of Ren tokens. Well, all right. This is a classic case of we drew one chariot and they drew two Rens, two chariots. Guess I'll see what we draw before I decide what to do. Like, I don't know how we could win other than drawing like literally like four consecutive epiphanies or something. Guess I'll block. double blocking in case, like, I don't want them to be able to play a removal spell to keep their creature around, you know? Really surprised they would spend Disdainful Stroke there. Like, that card doesn't really do anything. Disdainful Stroke basically keeps the game locked up. I mean, like, I'm gonna lose, don't get me wrong, but you have 4/7/7 reaches. Who cares about Goldspan Dragon? Maybe I'll draw something good, my own Wrenn or something like that, you know? Maybe they have two Disdainful Strokes. Maybe that's how we should take it. I do think that makes it much more likely. Okay, no, they're just playing pre-sideboarded. Well, I'm pretty sure I just chump two to live, and then makes it a little bit easier maybe without their flying blockers for me to chain stuff together, though still almost 0% to win. Let's get Burning Hands and Disdainful Stroke. Honestly, kind of don't hate because we saw Disdainful Stroke. I kind of don't hate the idea of putting in Ranger class. Me try something like this. Actually, I haven't played the mirror yet. Well, definitely going to play a Sentinel into Magda. Or try to, I suppose. I think I'm just going to attack. I think trading one treasure for two damage is fine because I think I'm about to jump way out ahead, and all I have in my hand are Disdainful Strokes, which I can't cast this turn. I'm not going to activate Chariot because I think it's too likely our opponent has like a Burning Hands and it just makes them lets them use their mana so well. I don't really think I can lose by doing nothing. Like whatever spell they had, now they're Burning Handsing. Yeah, see, at end of turn, so I would have done four less damage if I use the Chariot, and it makes them use their cards like kind of awfully. Like the best threat on the board just survives the best answer to it. I don't really feel I need to do anything differently this turn either. It's pretty, I mean, going to two against the, I don't know, seems like a lot. I think our opponent played. I don't think it's bad to burn hands to creatures, but I don't think our opponent should have accepted being hit by them. I should have put Quandrix Command in my deck. It's both for Chariot and Wrenn tokens. So the sand would be is like great if I draw green. I'm gonna keep. I mean, we're on the draw. We have a turn two Magda. If we have a even if we miss the green on turn one, if we have it by turn three for the tracker, it's pretty strong. Obviously, if we don't, then we're probably gonna lose, but are they getting priority from? Kind of happy like with being so far ahead on the board, like I can kind of just make them do something. If there's something as a Goldspan Dragon, it's probably the worst case because then they can attack and threaten to use Disdainful Stroke. This is like the best case scenario for us. We get to kill the token and they're dead. I mean, I don't know. We like probably put the counters on Magda. Are they just dead? Yeah, it doesn't matter what I do. Four, eight, 11, 13. All right, that was pretty good. We had really good draws in the second two games. Like it's one thing that like I didn't do anything special, but it's just one thing to keep an eye on. Like, that's really how you want to play these mid-range games, the way it was for us in the second and third game. Like, if you get a fast start on the board, you can trade answers for threats. And while you're hitting, you know, we're doing damage to the opponent's life total, the opponent is just trying to stabilize the board. They can't really catch up because you don't need to make those exchanges for very long. Now, on the flip side, if neither player has anything, you can kind of go haymaker counter, haymaker answer, and nobody's making any headway. So just small things like, you know, the Magda in both games basically provided so much value, our opponent just couldn't do anything. And I mean, they very obviously didn't choose not to play removal. We could tell they just didn't have it from the arena stops and stuff, so. Yeah, we'll keep here for sure. What are we up against? Rule of some sort. All right, we'll play. Doesn't matter, but I'm just gonna play Rockfall Veil. Thinks it makes us a little bit more deceptive. Ranger class, okay. Play this and this and Magda, I think. We don't really need to have Dragonfire for this turn. Also, in a world where they decide to be aggressive and attack and like play a Kovlar or something. Okay, so they're playing Jund. Sure. So they're probably gonna leave something back. Oh. Okay, fair enough. Gonna kill this now. I mean, it's kind of mediocre, but the truth is, I'd rather it be daytime on our opponent's turn. Yeah, it's fine. They're content to let us have all the mana we want. I am going to play a random make 4/4. It's pretty strong here. They might just be forced to suicide, depending on what's in their hand. Tracker at me only, huh? Okay, that's a draw. Now what? So now. Think I might go plus Ren, play dragon and pass, because then next turn I can make two Ren tokens. If they have removal for the dragon, is it possible that it's not, right? Because I would have just removed the token and killed Ren that turn. I could draw it. I also have no problem if they want to like use Ranger class to pump Storm Seeker, trading Dragon for it. I'm definitely going to block because I have another Magda in hand. Actually, yeah, let me block here. So this turn I can play a Ren and a Magda. Or I could play Innkeeper. Could I play it all? Innkeeper. So if I play this, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, so I'll just play everything. So now we're even protected from the Lair of the Hydra or a third creature with haste. Though I'm actually not in very good shape if they're able to kill the tree folk. Sure. Nah, lock the innkeeper. It's kind of rough if I draw another Magda, but. It's a good land to hit. Yeah, it looks like they're about to sack a clue to try to dig. Alternatively, they could attack with Lair of the Hydra. Okay. I'm probably going to lose without an answer to that. This time I can safely block though, because I can just make another one, I guess. That's a card. This card's really just so strong unanswered though. Like, basically, the only chance is if your opponent just hits an absolute ridiculous land glut. Which is, they also have two treasures, so. Okay, so now they're Probably drew one land trying to find a two mana removal. If they remove this, I die basically. Should I attack with the 8/8? Not going to. Yeah, that was a lucky draw. I'm surprised I didn't give it another turn just because you can get really lucky with the their deck is tricky. They have. Maybe I'll do something like this. Six. Ooh. Kind of just shave cards sometimes because don't know the deck list that well yet, my opponents and stuff. Right, this hand's fine. I mean, we have the good card. They have black. I wonder if they would ever bring in like duress type cards. Well, of course, I have redundancy now. Well, they have first crack now. First crack at the chariot. Wonder if I should have played a blue. Does probably not, I mean. Okay, I think they would still play it. Maybe they would play around Disdainful Stroke, but I'll just sit here like a dumbbell and hope that I get to Burning Hands the Chariot. This is like when I played against that other deck where I just didn't activate my Chariot. Like, I would be in bad shape if they just had it not activated the chariot. Because the problem is, it's hard. Now I can just sort of just tap out to play my own chariot. Only made one green. This card's really good, Reckless Stormseeker. Like, I'm in big trouble if, well, not big trouble because I have Wrynn also, because I'm just always have all the best cards, so. Rescinded my big trouble comment, and because they're playing 1/1s instead of creatures, guess. This is a nice combo for sure. I don't think anybody else has caught on yet to the Chariot Ren combo though, so that's good. I don't think it'll see much play. Probably just gonna lose, I guess. Oh, I have this, I guess. All right, well, I might lose, but we definitely have more game to play at this point. Another blue or another green. It's only one Ren left, so probably another blue because I have. The time walks. Well, don't mind me, just always having the best card. So if they kill this turn I lose. I don't. Well, I guess I have to like jump in Dragon's Fire. No, I'm speaking too soon. I don't really want to let that thing flip into nighttime and then lose control of it. Yeah, what I was gonna do there was attack with just Chariot and Goldspan and copy the Tree Folk. Right, those are some long matches. We went 3-0. Deck is really strong. Good job by Andrew Jessup building it. If you aren't a member of CFB Pro yet, head on over to channelfireball.com. If you're signing up, you can use code Huey. And it will help support me in my content. As always, I greatly appreciate you all watching. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.